गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ योर क्लास 8 साइंस चैप्टर 1, लास्ट डे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस इन विच द फर्स्ट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द सॉयल इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस दैट हाउ द सॉयल इज प्रिपेयर्ड बिफोर सोइंग द सीड्स एंड इट इज डन बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट एग्रीकल्चरल डिवाइसेस. टुडे here we are going to start our new topic. It is the application of manure and fertilizers. This is very very important thing in the production of the crop, that is the application of manures and fertilizers. Why these are important? Because these manures and fertilizers provide nutrients to the crop, because all these crops require certain nutrients for their growth. So they provide the nutrient to the soil, and if these soil that is rich in the nutrients, the plants are able to absorb these nutrients from the soil. Okay, so these manures and fertilizers are very important for the crops. So what is done in this, when the application and manures are introduced into the soil, so it renders the soil deficient in the nutrients. This reduces the crop yield, means when the soil is deficient in the nutrients, so the crop production will be reduced. So to overcome this problem, what is done? We use the different types of manure. One of the method to overcome this problem is the following. This process is known as this following. Following is the practice of leaving the field uncultivated. Suppose we have not cultivated this soil for few years. So what will happen? It will obtain all these nutrients from the surrounding and it will become this nutrient rich. But this is not possible, because we have to grow this crops every year. So how we can increase the nutrients in the soil? By using these. This is the manures, and by using fertilizers, we can grow the crops properly in proper amount. So how it is done? It is done with the help of this use of manures as well as the fertilizers. So first we will discuss about these manures. What are manures? Manures are organic nutrients. Okay, manure is rich in organic nutrient that is made by these plants parts and these dead bodies of animals. Okay, when these are decomposed into the soil, they convert into the nutrients, because these organic nutrients are the waste product of animals and plants. So it is called this manure, and manures are rich in organic nutrient. Manures are rich in organic nutrient. So manures are of three kinds, that is farmyard manure, compost and green manure. Okay, farmyard manure is, that is the consist of cattle dung. That is very common manure that we use. It is the farmyard manure. Like you have seen in the villages, the people, those who are rearing the different cattle, what they do, they store their dungs for in a place, and after some time this dung converts into manure. That is called this farmyard manure. After that, this second is compost. Compost is what? It is the manure obtained by the decomposition of dead plants and animal waste. It is obtained by the decomposition of dead plants and animal waste. When these are decomposed, they mix into the soil, and this is called this compost, because it is formed by this decomposing of the plant and animal waste. So this is the second type of organic nutrient. The third is, that is the green manure. Green manure is what? It is the manure that is consist of green plants which are plowed along with the soil. The green plants that are plowed into the soil, so these plants, they convert it into the green manures. When they are plowed, they convert into the green manures. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक न्यूट्रिएंट और ऑर्गेनिक मेन्योर एंड दीज ऑल आर रिच इन द न्यूट्रिएंट्स. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइप हाउ वी कैन इनरिच द सॉइल विद द न्यूट्रिएंट बाय यूज द विद द यूज ऑफ मेन्योर. नाउ द सेकंड मेथड इज इट इज बाय एडिंग फर्टिलाइजर्स. द सेकंड मेथड टू इनरिच द सॉइल विद द न्यूट्रिएंट इट इज बाय यूजिंग द फर्टिलाइजर्स. सो फर्टिलाइजर्स आर व्हाट? Fertilizers are inorganic chemical substances. Fertilizers are inorganic substances. Inorganic substances means these are made up of these chemical substances manufactured in the different factories. Okay. So these are called these chemical substances that are rich in the nutrients and that are introduced into the soil to increase the fertility of the soil. These are called as fertilizers. Main thing that we have to keep in the mind that is these are chemical substances, whereas this organic manure was, it was an organic substance, okay, and it is an inorganic substance. So there are different nutrients that are the plants require are nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium. So they provide these substances to the soil. There are some names of these chemical fertilizers are NPK, CAN. NPK means that the fertilizer can nitrogen, phosphorus and calcium. Sorry, nitrogen, phosphorus and nitrate. Okay, very commonly used fertilizer is, it is urea. Urea is a compound of nitrogen. That's why it's very commonly used chemical fertilizer is, it is urea. Okay, so these are the different fertilizers that we use in our field to enrich the soil with the nutrients. So there is one box that will inform us about what is the difference between manure and fertilizers. So the first is manures are natural substances. This is the manures are natural substances, whereas fertilizers are inorganic or chemical substance. The first and very important thing, ki manures are natural substances, fertilizers are inorganic substances. Manures contain organic matter in large quantity. Fertilizers do not contain the organic matter in large quantity. They are prepared in the fields. These are prepared in the factories. Fertilizers are prepared in the factories. Manures contain nutrient in a small quantity. It also very important point that the manures, they contain the nutrients in small quantities, and that's why they are needed in a large quantity. Fertilizers contain much higher quantity of nutrients. That's why the farmers, they generally use the fertilizers instead of this manure, because to form this manure, it takes very long time to form, whereas the fertilizers form very quickly. And one more advantage of this fertilizer, they contain this large amount of nutrients. That's why these fertilizers are preferred over these manures. Next is, manures do not cause pollution because these are organic substances. These are organic substances, that's why they do not cause pollution. Whereas these fertilizers, these are chemical substances, they do not decompose easily, so they cause this water pollution. So manures are not harmful, but they have this less amount of nutrients, whereas these fertilizers are harmful for the environment, but the advantage of this using fertilizer is they are very high quantity of nutrient. That's why fertilizers are used very frequently by the farmers. Okay, so this next is hazards of using fertilizers. How these fertilizers cause hazard to ourselves and to our environment. So as we know that fertilizers has increased or improved our soil, and it also increased the production of crop, but they cause this different types of pollution, especially this water pollution, soil pollution and water pollution. So that is what it is the hazard of this using fertilizers. And next is that is advantage of this using manures. So they improve the texture of soil because when they mix with the soil, they open the air channels of the soil. So the soil become this porous. They increase the water holding capacity of the soil. So they improve the texture of the soil. They increase the water holding capacity of the soil. They make the soil porous, due to which the exchange of gases takes place and increase in the aeration. Aeration means increase the flow of this air, so it is friendly of soil organisms like earthworm and microbes. So that is the advantage of using manures. Another method of this improving the soil, that is the crop rotation. Crop rotation is what? It is the method of growing different crops alternately. Means suppose we are growing some plants this year, we can grow another plant another year. Like it is written, the farmers grow crops like wheat or barley in the first year. First year they are growing this wheat and barley, then it is followed by growing leguminous plants. Leguminous plant, that this pulses plant like pea or soybean. Some leguminous plants, they are grown alternately because these leguminous plants help in the replacement of the soil with the nitrogen. They help in the replenish, means that they increase the amount of nitrogen into the soil. So this crop rotation is also important. Then it is how leguminous plant increase the soil fertility. As we know, the plants require nitrogen in a very large amount because they are helpful in the synthesis of the protein, this nitrogen gas. And as we know, the nitrogen is in a very large amount in our atmosphere. It is 78%. But this nitrogen cannot be utilized by the plant directly until or unless this nitrogen is not converted into its compounds. Okay, so this is done in our atmosphere, but in the case of certain leguminous plants, they contain certain bacteria that is called this nitrogen fixing bacteria, like azotobacter. Okay, these nitrogen fixing bacteria, these are found in the root nodules. See, this is the nodules, an outgrowth in the roots of leguminous plant. These are called this root nodules. This is the place where these bacteria are found. So what these bacteria do, they absorb this nitrogen from this atmosphere and convert it into its compound, so that this nitrogen can be utilized by the plant. This process is known as this nitrogen fixation, means conversion of nitrogen into its compound by these nitrogen fixing bacteria. So this method, this is called this nitrogen fixation. So what they are doing, they are increasing the fertility of the soil. How? Because they are providing this nitrogen to the soil. So all these things are done by these nitrogen fixing bacteria. They fix the nitrogen into the soil, and it is an important phenomenon to increase the fertility of the soil. So all these methods that we have discussed, by using manures, by using fertilizers, by crop rotation, and by using these leguminous plant in the soil, all these methods, what these do, they provide the soil more amount of nutrients so that the plants can grow properly. So it is also one of the important practice during the crop production. So this is, now it is completed. Now we are going to discuss the oral questions that is given in your book. Name three types of manures. So it is the farmyard manure, compost, and green manure. It is the farmyard manure, compost, and green manure. What is the importance of leguminous plants? They help in the fixation of nitrogen because they contain the nitrogen fixing bacteria. Name the method of cropping in which different crops are grown alternately. It is called this crop रोटेशन, इट इज कॉल्ड दिस क्रॉप रोटेशन. व्हाट इज फाउंड इन द पार्ट